Hello, grade 12 students. Welcome to our new normal class. And today, we are now start to discuss the midterm lesson in health optimizing physical education, which is the modern and contemporary. At the end of this lesson, the students will able to determine the modern contemporary dance, identify the famous choreographer in modern and contemporary dance, apply the characteristics of modern dance and elements of contemporary, and lastly, choreograph their own 1-minute dance routine in modern or contemporary dance. So let's get started. So let's talk about the modern dance. Begun at the turn of 19th century, the spirit of change as in the air and was contagious among people in many different areas of arts and dance. Modern dance began with the choice to move away from the rules, structures, and ideas of the past to move to more individually creative theory of dance. In a modern dance, usually they are individual performance. Modern dance does have no rules and form. Each modern dance has developed a personal style of dancing and therefore a way of preparing their dancer. Modern dance, it is an experience in movement. Dance is a movement. Movement is a life, and it surrounds you every moment. Modern dance also, it is a base on the highest individuals or personal movements based upon the dancers or the choreographer artistic intent. In a modern dance, usually the choreographer or the dancer creates a new modern dance based on this music. If it is fast, medium, or slow, so they don't have a rule on how to create their movements. And they are personalized also. They are created by them some. So here are the characteristics of modern dance. Number one, no set curriculum, no particular music, no particular costume, no particular body type, natural, pedestrian, curvature of the body, parallel position of the hips to toe, release of the neck when the head is dropped, stabilization of the pelvis, cause and effect, action and reaction, weighted use of gravity, flexibility and articulation of spine, contraction and release, softness into a floor, rebellion against ballet. So to the summary of the characteristic of the modern dance, they are no suggested music, no more suggested a movement, no more suggested body type. If you are fat, you are thin, you are welcome to dance the modern dance. Usually the modern dance, they are stabilization of the pelvis, wherein the tusa hips, okay, in the hips. Next is the paces of the dance, modern dance, from 90s to present. From 90s to 1940, the social, economic, and the politics changes raise new questions about morality, rights, freedom, and the human condition. This new dance was not beautiful to the accustomed patrol, but the beauty had not been defined. Early modern dancers look behind the dominant tradition of Western theatrical dance in order to give their dance a more communicative power. They drew a archaic and exotic source for inspiration. There was no fancy music or sensory. So here are the famous modern dance choreographers. So let's talk about Isadora Duncan from 1877 to 1927. Isadora Duncan, also known as the mother of the modern dance. True ballet was ugly and against nature and wanted a style of dance that was free and natural. Had limited success in America. She was founded the new system of interpretative dance, blending poetry, music, and rhythmic of nature. She also explored concepts through dance, but most of their dance are influenced by Greek sculpture, flowy movements, and nature. Next choreographer, a famous choreographer, is Arut St. Denis from 1878 to 1968. Ruth had a vision for a new form of dance with form as well as freedom, and actually a choreographer dance that was repeated each time performed. She was birthed, designed to be a communication on the spiritual level. Ruth also a choreography has Eastern influence from countries such as India, Egypt, Cyprus, and many more for the Middle East. She was particularly interested in exotic lands and the dance step costume and settings associated with them, as well as in using a dance to explore spiritually. It was married her dance partner, namely Ted Sean, and they developed the dance company of Danish One. Ruth is the teacher of Martha Graham, Doris Humphrey, and Charles L. Mott. Next is the Big Four. The Big Four from 1910 to 1945. The main choreographers during this period were Martha Graham, Doris Humphrey, Charles Wildman, and Hanley Wong. The major theme of this work create about the American spirit. This dance rejected extended movement source and turned to basic human movements experience using a breathing and walking. They transformed this natural action into dance movement. Next is the Martha Graham. When you say Martha Graham, the 1894 to 1991, she was known as the mother of the American dance. Graham developed the principle of deconstruction and release. Graham also, the original techniques was rooted in the form of expressionism. She linked movement to emotional expression and develop a vocabulary to communicate emoticons, exploring deep within her own physique. She famous work was the Apalachiani Spring, and she was founded the Maria Graham Dance Company in 1926. Next is the Doris Humphrey. Doris Humphrey, 1895 to 1989, Humphrey was the leading eloise in Danish One, create the Henry Wedmond School and Company with Charles Wedmond, create the theory of fall and recovery. Themes of social organization were important. First, to use an example in peace versus the social dance or the solo dancer. And his famous work was Water Study. Let's talk about the contemporary dance. When you say contemporary dance, it is an expressive dance technique which is a combination of the variety of dance, modern, jazz, lyrical, and classical ballet. It is a performing arts that involves rhythmic body movements, within a given space, choreographed based on this music beat. It was developed in 1950 in America and Europe. So here are the eight elements of the contemporary. The first one is the theme, the most basic element of the dance. What is the theme of the dance? What is the main ingredients of the dance? Next is the design. The design is the pattern of the movement in time and space. What is the arrangement? The arrangement of the steps, particular in speed of the time or the space of the stage. Next is the movement. The movement is the bodily action of the dancer that includes its steps. Usually, movements is the main elements of the contemporary because it is an expressive movement. Kinakailangan na ang mga movements ay they are emotional and expressive and they are communicative in the audience. Next is the technique. The technique is the skills of the movement executed by the dancer. How you execute the particular movements. Next is the music. The most closely of the dance. The auditory background within the dancer movement. Sasayaw ka ba kung walang music? Sasayaw ka ba na may music pero walang gumagalaw? So movements and music are correlated. Next is the costume and the body paraphernalia. Properties worn by the dancer that helps reflect the message, costume, and beliefs. So costume, the purpose of the costume is to reflect the visual effect of our audience, to know the main theme of our dance. Next, the choreography. The choreography is the figure and the steps in dancing that enable the dancer to perform in an organized manner. Scenery, the last element of the contemporary wherein the background of or the setting where the dance is performed to make it more realistic and enrichment. Mostly the contemporary, they are putting a background to more likely and lively and to more realistic of what they dancing. So here are the famous or the pioneers of the contemporary dance. We have Isadora Duncan, Martin Graham, and Mercy Cunegra. So these are the three pioneers of the contemporary that they believe dancers should have freedom to movement, allowing their bodies to free express their innermost feelings and thought. In the contemporary, there are no specific movement. You will create your own movement based on the music that you are selected. Before we end our lesson, let's try to answer the warm-up in the health optimizing physical education wherein you can see the crossword. We have the crossword in your module. The crossword have the same definition, the definition that written on the below of the crossword, and then identify what are they. I think our lesson for this day is end. So I hope you learned something from me. See you next video lesson. Good day and God bless. Goodbye.